This video is designed to give you a quick overview of a SAS University Edition. This is a free version of the statistical analysis package that is available for educational purposes. It contains the base, statistics, and IML packages of the licensed version. Although the University Edition does not contain the higher-end graphics procedures, it does include the SG graphics options. It runs in a virtual window, so it can be used across many computing platforms. But unlike the licensed version, it can only use 1 GB of the system memory, so it is not suitable for analysis of large data sets with complex models. You begin a session using a virtual window and access the package using an internet browser. When the program initially starts, on the left will be a list of files in the My Folders directory. This is the directory that the virtual window can use, but is also one in which you can access within your computer platform. On my machine, it is in a subdirectory called My Folders in the SAS University Edition directory. I provided a small data set for the first week's analysis. It is a text file with the name spaw1.sas. This is short for Statistics and Plant Agriculture Week 1. It contains 100 seed weights of 10 samples of two plant species, corn and sunflower. Place this file in the directory that you are using to share with the virtual window. Files labeled with a .sas extension are called SAS program files. These are the files that you use to provide data and the instructions for manipulation and analysis. You can open one up by using a right click on the mouse and selecting Open, or you can drag the file into the window on the right. Now that we've opened this file, you see that there are three tabs activated: a code window, a log window, and a result window. In the licensed version of SAS, the code window is called the editor window. In the ribbon, there are a number of options available. These options will change depending on which is the active window. We will begin with the code window. This is the window that you use to provide data and all instructions for its manipulation and analysis. You have complete control on the contents of the code window. You can type into the window, you can paste, copy, save the contents as a file, and open previous files. There is also a Save As provision, which lets you give a different name to a modified version of the file. When files are saved by this window, they are given the default extension of .sas. These are referred to as SAS program files. This file is a simple text file that contains all the data and instructions for the analysis of an experiment. You can save this file for recall in the future, make additions or changes for reanalysis, or email the file to another person who can perform the same analysis on their computer, using either the university or the licensed edition. Once the instructions for an analysis have been placed into this window, then they can be submitted to the SAS system for program execution. When SAS is performing a series of instructions, it will report in the log window what has happened at each stage and any errors and warnings. If there are errors, correct the errors in the code and resubmit. When the results of an analysis are available, these are reported in the result window. Tables and figures in the result window can be saved as a file. The file types are HTML, PDF, or as a Word rich text format file. The example file contains 20 rows of data arranged in 3 columns. Each row is an observation. The first column is the observation number. The second column is the plant species. And the third column is the weight in grams of 100 seeds. SAS can use the data in any format, but the easiest for most users to manipulate is this row column format. This is exactly the form it is in a spreadsheet. Instead of having the data in a file, I could have pasted it from my original data source using copy-paste. To illustrate, I will close this file by deleting the tab. I will then create a new file using the menu option. I will then switch to an Excel spreadsheet and copy the data area. I can now return to the SAS code window and paste the data into the window. Since this is a virtual window, I have to use the Control-V command. Note that the data appears just like the SAS file we had opened earlier. The coding statements that you use in this package are the same as those for the license edition. These are covered in the other videos in this series. However, there are a couple of important statements when you are using the University Edition. I will open up a version of this file which contains the additional codes for the analysis of this dataset. Note that I can have multiple files open at the same time. This can be helpful if you are using program lines that you've created for other analyses. When using the column format for data, the spacing between columns can be spaces or tab stops. If the data set has been pasted in from a spreadsheet, the columns will be separated by tab stops. You can tell what it is by placing your cursor at the end of a column. Now use the right arrow key to move the cursor. If it jumps to the next column, then it is a tab stop and not a series of spaces. In the license version, it does not matter what it is. But in the University Edition, the default setting is spaces, not tab stops. Unless this is changed, it will not recognize that there are three columns in this data set here. So when you have tab stops, you must add one more command line before the input line. It is called an infile command, and it is written as this: infile space data lines space delimiter equal single quote 09 single quote and an X and end in a semicolon. This specifies that tab stops rather than spaces are to be used to separate columns. This is just a unique feature of the University Edition. The second statement applies if you're using SAS macro files as part of an analysis, as illustrated in this portion of code. This particular line is calling a SAS macro called pdmix800.sas. I have saved my macros in a file in the subdirectory SAS macros in the My Folders area. In this case, there is only one file in there called pdmix800.sas. The University Edition can only access files that are in the My Folders region. To specify the file name and location, you begin the sequence with a forward slash and the word folders, followed by a forward slash and the logical name of the directory that it is found in. So in my case, it is my folders forward slash SAS macros forward slash and then the name, full name of the file, and that is pdmix800.sas. One last item relates to the help menus. To access these, select the question mark in the upper right and go to SAS Product Documentation. This takes you to the materials for the entire SAS system. For the stat procedures, follow the S link and choose the SAS Stat option. Select the Documentation tab. And the user guide for the most recent version is listed, along with a file that indicates what's new in this particular version compared to previous versions of the software. Select the HTML version of the user guide. The PDF is a massive file. All you need is the HTML version. Once you're on this landing page, you can bookmark the page to save you time at accessing it in the future. This is the list of all statistical procedures. You can now go to a particular procedure. In this case, I will select the GLIMIX procedure. Here you will find a description, an overview of the procedure, the syntax, and example data sets and example analyses using this procedure. Under syntax, all possible statements are given, along with explanations of their use and their options. To illustrate, I will select Model, and you will find that there is a wide range of options available for this particular statement. One of the options is the method of computing the degrees of freedom of the denominator for an F-test. So, for example, if we were interested in applying the Kenward-Roger correction to the degrees of freedom calculation, we could use the Kenward-Roger option. But not only do you have a list of the option method, it also provides information about a reference to the method, some notes about the method, and a greater information about the computation. And this applies to many of the other options that are available. So when you have particular choices in terms of what method you are going to apply to an analysis, you can work your way through and determine what is the most appropriate for the type of scenario that you have. This concludes a brief overview of the University Edition.